Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is a second lecture of sugar industry. In this lecture we are going to discuss on manufacture of sugar from sugarcane. If you are watching first time to my YouTube channel, so please subscribe my channel, share my channel and press the bell icon button for latest videos notification. Let me start. In this lecture, we are going to study manufacture of sugar from sugarcane. Means, already we discussed about the manufacture of sugar from the sugarcane, means it involves different steps. As we know that the manufacture of sugar from sugarcane involves different steps such as raw materials, extraction of juice, purification of juice, concentration of juice, evaporation of juice. And finally, there is drying of the sugar and packing of the sugar. So these are the steps involved in the manufacture of the sugar from sugarcane. So we are going to see today three different steps, that is raw materials, extraction of juice and purification of juice, that is nothing but the clarification of the juice. As we know that where the sugar can be manufactured from the sugar cane, where this is the sugar cane is a very important raw material for the manufacture of sugar. How you can see here, sugar, that is sugar cane. Sugar cane is a we can see here harvesting of sugar cane. Approximately 8 to 15 feet of height we can see here. It consisting of 11 to 15% of the sugar and 70% of the water is there. When this harvesting sugar is cutted and towards the further transport toward the sugar industry. Here this sugar cane, which is made up of different joints, is known as the eyes. This is called as the eye. Where this cover which is known as the rind. You can see this sucrose or this sugar which is covered with a hard structure like called as the rind, and those are joined by the eyes, are known as the nodes, that is called as the nodes. Once the sugar, the sugar cane is harvested, approximately up to 8 to 15 feet of height is there, and it consisting of 11-15% of the sugar. Once there is a complete growth and cutted into for the sugar and transport towards the sugar industries, where we can see transportation may be of different types, where the trucks and other things can be used for the transportation. Once if it is cutted and immediately sent towards the sugar industry, because there is no delay of the cutting of this sugar cane, because there may be the loss of the weight less can be possible. Next, extraction of juice. As we know that once the sugar cane which is received in a sugar industry, first there is extraction of juice. Very important, juice can be extracted. Whenever before going to the extraction of the juice, this all the cane sugar which is washed and chopped into different small pieces, and further they are pressed. From the pressing, the juice can be extracted. Here we can see in this picture from the left hand side, all the sugar cane which are washed through a water jets. Continuously there is conveyors are there, means there are belts are there, rollers are there. With the help of the rollers, they are moved into a certain way towards the front side. Continuously they are washed with the water. Once they are washed, they are cutting into further step is chopping. Chopping is nothing but the those sugar cane which is of 8 feet or 10 feet, further cut into the small pieces, that is called as the chopping process. Here the sugar cane can be cut into small pieces with the help of the cane knives, and further they are pressed. Means there is a pressing of these small pieces of the cutted small pieces of the sugar cane. With the help of these, their juice can be extracted. See here the extraction of juice. First of all, this extraction of juice can be done through a mechanical mill, where there is a top roller is there. Here you can see triangular pattern. There is a mill which having a triangular roller pattern, means there are three different rollers are there. This is a top roller and this is the bottom roller. Here you can see this is the top roller and this is the bottom roller. And top roller, which consisting of there is a rotation, is the counter clockwise means in anti clockwise direction rotation will be there, and these bottom rollers will be they rotate in a clockwise direction. In between these rollers, juice, that is cane sugar, which is transferred through where the pressing of the means complete pressing of this sugar cane can be done with the a top roller, means approximately the pressure of that juice, means pressure of that how much pressure can be regulated by the top roller, means in between these two between the three rollers there sugar cane can be passed. And here at the bottom you can see there is a juice tray is there, means with the help of the pressing the juice is extracted and collected in the this juice tray. And further the unwanted sugar cane, that is known as the baggage, which is sent towards the outside. Here very important that first mill extract 60 to 70% of the juice, means from the that cane sugar in the first mill there is 60 to 70% of the juice can be obtained, and the remaining juice is obtained from the baggage. Baggages are nothing but waste of the sugar cane after removing the juice from the sugar cane, that is known as the baggage. Likewise, the mills are continuous in a way, in a series. There are 3 to 4 mills, maybe sometimes 5 mills, 6 mills can be there in a series. Means all the sugar cane pass through first mill, second mill, third mill, fourth mill. Likewise, the juice can be extracted. Means with the help of the passing the different mills, 95 to 99% of the juice can be extracted. Here we can see second baggage consisting of 22 to 24% of the juice contained passing through the second mill, third mill, and the fourth mill. Likewise, here we can see the series where this is the first mill. Let us consider this is the first mill where we can obtain 60 to 70% of the juice is there, and further juice can be collected in the bottom of the juice tray, where the baggage can be further passed to the second mill. Again, you will get the here some of the juice which is from the baggage. Further, this baggage sent towards third mill. Likewise, third mill, fourth mill. At the end, this is very important. At the end, in the last mill, water is added to the baggage and sent back to the second mill, where the further final baggage can be here, where it consisting of a certain amount of sucrose, that is sugar juice, were further added with the water and sent towards the second mill. Continuously again they are passed through the second, third, fourth, and the fifth mill. So where in this way 95 to 99% of the juice can be obtained from the remaining baggage, where the certain process that is called as the compound imbibition process. Means what? In the last mill water is added and further extracted through the second, third, and fourth mill is known as the compound imbibition process. In this way, extraction of juice can be obtained 95 to 99% of the juice from these mills. Next is purification of juice. Once juice is obtained, we have to purify. That is, purification of juice is also known as the clarification. Here it is clarification is there. The cane juice from milling station pumped into a weighing tank approximately 8 to 10 tons after weighing the juice and sent for purification process. What is this clarification? Clarification is nothing but the purification of process. Initially, where they are passed through the screen to remove the floating impurities. Initially, what we have to do? Because we have the lot of juice in the formation of the tons, where the floating impurities are initially they are removed by means of the putting the screens, where the screened juice having pH of 5.1 to 5.7 contains soluble impurities. These soluble impurities like soil, proteins, coloring materials and other materials are eliminated by the clarification process. Very simple. From the juice, the floating materials can be removed through the screens, with the help of the screens, and further the soluble impurities can be removed by the help of the clarification process. This clarification process involved three important steps, such as clarification by limidification process, and second sulfitation process, and third one carbonation process. What is clarification process? Very simple. Here the clarification process is a process in which these soluble impurities are removed with the help of the adding the calcium oxide, that is with the help of the lime lification process. The screen juice transferred into the lification tanks. Here we can see here the right hand side, there is a circular conical bottom tanks are there fitted with the steam. The juice is neutralized by adding the lime, where we have to initially add the lime, because the process is known as the clarification by lime lification process. Approximately 1 pound of calcium oxide per ton is used for the lification process. Initially, the juice is heated to boiling. In this process, insoluble salts are precipitated or coagulated as calcium oxide is added and precipitated out. Once they are insoluble salts are coagulated or suspended particles are precipitated, these thick scum layer or mud are removed mechanically through the filter press. We have to filter it through the filter press, where the filter cakes are used as the manure means, where the filtrate can be used for known as the raw sugar, and where the residues are nothing but the filter cakes are used as the manure. Here you can say as the manure, where the juice obtained from the lime lification, that is filtrate, where the after filtering, where the juice is obtained is known as a lime lification. Clear brownish concentrated liquid known as the raw sugar. This is very important, where the filtrate consisting of a brownish color concentrated liquid is known as the raw sugar. This is known as the raw sugar. Where in India, raw sugar is converted into white sugar by means of sulfitation or carbonation process. Therefore, sulfitation process as well as carbonation process, we can choose it as per the industry favorable, where sulfitation process and the carbonation process are required for the brown colored sugar, that is raw sugar, can be converted into the white sugar. Let me see sulfitation process first. Here in this process, very simple, sulfitation process or carbonation process, both can be used to convert raw sugar into white sugar. In this process, sulfur dioxide gas is passed through an outlet pipe provided at the bottom of the tank containing lime juice, heated about 75 degrees Celsius. This process is called as the first sulfitation. Very simple, as the juice is, that is lime juice obtained, heated at 75 degrees Celsius, and further, where through the bottom SO2 gas is passed, is called as the sulfitation process, that is first sulfitation. Now the first sulfitated juice transferred into second tank. The SO2, that is sulfur dioxide, is passed to maintain pH of 5.5 and heated again to 103 degrees Celsius. Again, the suspended particles are precipitated and removed. This is called as the double sulfitation. This is very important. Here, sulfitation process is through carried out in a two different sulfitation process, that is first sulfitation and the second sulfitation. In this first sulfitation, there is a heated approximately 75 degrees Celsius. In the second sulfitation, heated about 100 degrees Celsius, that is 100 to 105 degrees Celsius. With this, the suspended particles or impurities are removed. It's called as the double sulfitation. The clear juice obtained sent to evaporation process. Here you can see the chemical reaction, that is excess of calcium can be removed by the calcium oxide plus H2SO4, where the sulfur dioxide is passed into the solution, it formed into H2SO4, calcium sulfur trioxide plus 2H2O, where here the water can be removed through the evaporation. Next is carbonation process, where the lime can be removed, means the raw sugar can be converted into white sugar by means of either sulfitation process or carbonation process. But second is the carbonation process. In the carbonation process, very simple, there is carbon dioxide is used. Where in the sulfitation process, we have seen that sulfur dioxide is used. In this carbonation process, the lime juice is heated about 50 to 55 degrees Celsius in a tank, and carbon dioxide gas is passed to the juice till alkalinity is reached. The juice containing impurities are precipitated. Here also, the juice containing impurities are precipitated through the CO2 gas. It is then filtered through a plate and frame filter press. The clear juice obtained again rise to boiling temperature. Once again, you have to add the carbon dioxide the certain impurities are soluble, precipitated, and these impurities can be again filtered through the frame filter press, and the clear juice obtained rise to certain boiling point temperature, means again you will get the white color, transparent of liquid of juice can be obtained, that is sugar juice can be obtained. The final clear juice obtained sent to again evaporation, where we can see calcium hydroxide plus CO2, it form into calcium carbonate plus water. Here the calcium carbonate is very simple, it is water soluble, it can be easily removed. So likewise, the raw sugar can be converted into white sugar by means of sulfitation or carbonation process. So in this video we studied about three important steps, that is raw material, extraction of juice, and clarification, that is purification of juice by clarification method. If you like my video, please subscribe and share my channel. So with this I will stop here. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you so much.